إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Brothers and sisters in Islam, من أعظم مقاصد الإسلام هو وحدة الصف المؤمن والمحبة والمودة التي تكون بين أفراد المجتمع المؤمن. One of the greatest significance of a believing community is the oneness of that community, the unity, the affection, the love, the mercy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran says, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةٌ. Indeed, the believers are just brothers. وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم فيما أخرج مسلم، مثل المؤمنين في توادهم وتراحمهم وتعاطفهم كمثل الجسد الواحد، إذا اشتكى منه عضو تداعى له سائر الجسد بالسهر والحمى. The similitude, the likeness of the Muslim Ummah, of the community of believers, is like one body. The likeness, once it comes to the mutual love, mercy, affection, is like one body. When a limb, just the nail, experiences pain, the rest of the body will feel it. When one of your limbs is having trouble, the rest of your body is being troubled as well. ولذلك, in order to achieve this goal, in order to accomplish this, our religion, Islam, advised us to the one thing which will lead to this, which is سلامة الصدر, that your heart, spiritual heart, your spiritual chest is free from hate, envy, dislike, resentment to another believer. And you're noticing I'm using the term believers intentionally, and all the ahadith used the word believers, which is the second level in that religion. Muslims who say La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah, and they pray, but they have not attained that level of belief. They have not reached the reality of faith. They may not do what I'm talking about, but they are still Muslims. We're not labeling them not to be Muslims. They are Muslims. But they have not attained that level of faith that can prevent them from resentment, from hate, from jealousy, destructive jealousy. Only people who attain iman, faith in Allah, will be stopped because of that consciousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because they have the taqwa. Salamatu sadr, that your heart, spiritual heart, is free from any resentment to another believer, another Muslim. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said this on the tongue of the believers. وَالَّذِينَ جَاءُوا مِن بَعْدِهِمْ يَقُولُونَ رَبَّنَا اغْفِرْ لَنَا وَلِإِخْوَانِنَا الَّذِينَ سَبَقُونَا بِالْإِيمَانِ وَلَا تَجْعَلْ فِي قُلُوبِنَا غِلًّا لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا رَبَّنَا. And those who came after them, they make this dua. O Allah, forgive our shortcomings. A believer always looks down upon himself. Always. Forgive my sins and the sins of those who passed away before us. And that sends a message to those who cursed the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And it is actually a religion for them. Like he says, Subhanallah, Subhanallah, Subhanallah. For them, oh Allah, curse Omar, curse Omar, curse Omar. That's how they make hasanat. Curse Uthman, curse Uthman. That's how they make hasanat. ولذلك, when somebody insulted one of the companions in front of Omar ibn Abdul Aziz radiyallahu anhu, rahimahullah, he said to him, أُمِرْنَا بِالْاِسْتِغْفَارِ لَهُمْ. And here you are insulting him. We were commanded to ask Allah to forgive them. And you're insulting them. وَالَّذِينَ جَاءُوا مِن بَعْدِهِمْ يَقُولُونَ رَبَّنَا اِغْفِرْ لَنَا وَلِإِخْوَانِنَا الَّذِينَ سَبَقُونَ بِالْإِيمَانِ. موضوع الشاهد, وَلَا تَجْعَلْ فِي قُلُوبِنَا غِلًّا لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. And place no resentment. Remove all type of resentment, Ya Rab, in our hearts to the believers. Brothers and sisters in Islam, when that Boston marathon, whatever it is, took place, I knew in the depth of my heart what is going inside the mind of the majority of Muslims. Ya Rab, let it not be a Muslim. Isn't that it? Ya Rab, we want to find our comfort. We came here. We have children here. We gotta plan things here. Ya Rab. We went through a lot after 9/11. That's what's been happening. And in spite of the fact that it's never proven that he's a Muslim yet, but yet we have learned that some Muslims got attacked in America because of Islamophobia. And now, how can we face this? You see, America has been hearing one side of the story. Fox News, kill the infidels where you find them, snipe them, wait for them. That's what they've been hearing. But they don't realize that these verses are taken out of context. And they deserve an explanation. America, yes, deserves an explanation about Islam. Now I'm tying this to what I started with. How can we do this if we cannot love one another? If we resent one another? How? We have to work together to be able to produce this. Individual efforts will not get us anywhere. And that is why we pray together. That is why the reward for observing Jama'ah is 26 times praying by yourself. Because when you come to the congregation, the unity is there. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Salamatu Sadr is the key to Jannah. Salamatu Sadr, having a heart, a spiritual one, which is free from hate, resentment, envy towards another Muslim, makes you the best Muslim. في سنن ابن ماجه من حديث عبد الله بن عمرو رضي الله عنهما سئل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عن أفضل الناس. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was asked about the best of people. اسمع, listen. كل مخموم القلب صدوق اللسان. The best of the believers, the best of the Muslims are those who have a heart which is mahmoom. And they always speak the truth. He has a truthful tongue. The Sahaba, the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Ya Rasulullah, O Messenger of Allah, we know what a truthful tongue is. But what do you mean by having a mahmoom heart? I use the Arabic version for it literally because there is no such an English word. English word would be somebody who is dummy. He's walking around, people are plotting about him, and he doesn't even think about it. People are talking about him, he doesn't even worry about it. People may be insulting him, he doesn't even respond. People may be trying to cheat him, he doesn't care. You call this dummy. He said, مخموم القلب, the one who has a مخموم heart, التقي, النقي, لا سيئة ولا إثم ولا حسد ولا غل. He is righteous, pious, pure. He doesn't have any ill intentions. He thinks positive about other people. He expects his Muslim brother to be a truth teller.
He expects his Muslim brother to be honest. And he's treating him on that basis. Taqi, naqi, no sin, no envy, no oppression. That is the heart. Brothers and sisters in Islam, في مسند الإمام أحمد رحمه الله حديث أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه أنس says كنا جلوسا مع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم We were sitting with the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم one day in the masjid Before somebody entered into the masjid He said, يطلع عليكم رجل من أهل الجنة. In a little bit, someone from the dwellers of heaven, of paradise, will enter the masjid. Of course, we understand this, that he received revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Messenger of Allah is not distributing Jannah. No. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to him that this man who is about to enter is one of the dwellers of Jannah. وَمَا يَنْطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَىٰ He does not speak out of his vain desire because of revelation. A very simple man entered the masjid His beard is dropping water from the traces of wudu, ablution, and he's placing his shoe under his left armpit. The following day, the same gathering, the same exact thing happened. Before this man from Al-Ansar entered, الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم said يطلع عليكم رجل من أهل الجنة someone from the dwellers of Jannah about to enter the third day three days in a row the same exact thing happened Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As رضي الله عنهما decided to follow this man and find out what does he do to be named a dweller of Jannah while he's still walking in the face of this earth. He made up a story. He requested from him to overnight in his house three nights. He stayed in his house for three nights. Here is the statement which he made. He doesn't do more than what we do. Now, أهل الإرجاء والمرجاء ومش عارف إيه. The people of الإرجاء يقول لك أهو شايف أهو ما بيصليش ولا مش عارف إيه وحيروح الجنة. يعني يا سبحان الله the companion who went and stayed with him عبد الله بن عمرو بن العاص. يعني عبد الله بن عمرو بن العاص in particular his father got him married the first night of the wedding he prayed tahajjud the whole night عمر بن العاص came in the morning asking how is your husband asking his wife how is your husband قالت نعم الرجل لربه What a good man he is to his Lord. I haven't even seen him. He used to fast every day. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, Ya Abdullah, fast the fasting of Dawood, of David, day and day, or Monday or Thursday. He insisted on fasting every day. Or he decided to do a day and a day. And when he got old, he wished that he heard the advice of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I'm saying this because the people in Murji'ah, The people of Al-Irja, the people who say all what you have to say, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah, believe in your heart, you go to Jannah. What is the evidence? Right here. He went and he slept with him in the house. He did not do a whole lot. لا بيصلي ولا بيعمل حاجة وراح الجنة هو. لا. It's not the way it is. Who went? And he said he doesn't do a whole lot. Except that when he turns around in his bed, he says, Allahu Akbar, Subhanallah. After the third day is over, he said, listen, I made up a story to stay with you. But this is the situation, and I'm puzzled by it. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, 3 days in a row, said about you that you're a dweller of Jannah. And I had to make up that story to come and see what you do. And I haven't really found you doing anything extra than we do. What is it? He said, by Allah, nothing more than what you seen. But there is one thing. After he's about to leave, he said, come back. Maybe that's it is. Before I go to sleep, I make sure that there is no hate, no resentment, no envy, no dislike in that heart for a Muslim. For a Muslim. بهذه بلغت. This is what got you. This is difficult. It's not easy. Brothers and sisters in Islam, it's very easy to hate. Very easy to hate. Very easy to resent others. Very easy. Very easy. It is difficult to have a clean heart, free from all of this. Brothers and sisters in Islam, a believer has a higher goal with his life. He knows that every word that he utters is recorded. ما ينطق من قول إلا لديه رقيب عتيد. Word. One word. لأنت تسمع هذا الحديث وتعجب لمن يطلق لسانه. إن الرجل، والحديث في صحيح البخاري، حديث سهل بن سعد الساعدي رضي الله عنه، قال صلى الله عليه وسلم، the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says، إن الرجل ليتكلم بالكلمة من سخط الله لا يلقي لها بالا وتهوي به في النار 70 خريفا. A man or a woman will say one word, one sentence, yeah. Carelessly, he doesn't pay attention, and it will earn him the anger and the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One sentence, one word, and it can lead him into hell, the distance of 70 years traveling until he reaches the depth of hell. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, amsik. Amsik. Why? Because if you speak ill, this will lead to resentment, to hate. Amsik alayka hada. Hold that tongue. قل لعبادي يقول التي هي أحسن إن الشيطان ينزغ. When we speak to one another, make sure that you choose the words carefully. Because if you choose the wrong word, shaitan will come and trigger the recipient of that word. And he will cause him to develop resentment against you. A lot of us, we live in America here, freedom of choice. Freedom of speech. يقول لك حرية الحديث. وحرية الكلام. I have the right to say whatever I want to say. لا يا حبيبي. There is a higher banner. You come under it. No, you're not. Every word that comes out, whether it's for you or against you, watch. Watch that tongue. Another reason, brothers and sisters in Islam, for hatred is being jealous of another Muslim. Having jealousy. إياكم والحسد. Be aware of jealousy. Because if you're jealous of that person, the moment that his name is mentioned, you're not going to like it. Watch. Another reason, brothers and sisters in Islam, for hatred is walking around the community and speaking ill about members of the community. لا يدخل الجنة نمام. A person who does this does not enter Jannah. Listen, if the matter is serious, address it in a different way. But you see, when I go and speak bad about you to someone else, that person is going to dislike you. And if I do this here, that person is going to dislike you. And you're going to end up with a fiasco. Everybody is disliking everybody because of rumors, because of envy, because of backbiting, ghibah, because of namima. And a lot of the brothers and the sisters do not realize that the actual definition of backbiting is that you speak about your brother or sister in their absence and say something that they resent. They would not like it to be said about them. One of the brothers speak to me, this brother does, ya akhi, but this true sheikh. I said, في صحيح مسلم, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, أتدرون ما الغيبة? Do you know what backbiting is? قال الله ورسوله أعلم. Allah and His Messenger know best. He said, صلى الله عليه وسلم, ذكرك أخاك بما يكره. That you say something about your brother in his or her absent, your sister in her absent, that they would dislike it. قالوا يا رسول الله, they said, O Messenger of Allah, أرأيت إن كان فيه, what if I said about him or her is true, is correct, is accurate? قال, he said, صلى الله عليه وسلم, إن كان فيه فقد اغتبته. If what you said about your brother is true, this still called backbiting. وإن لم يكن فيه فقد بهته. And if it is not true, then you have slandered him, which is a higher offense. ورد في الصحيح, الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم spoke about the mother of the believers, صفية رضي الله عنها, in front of عائشة رضي الله عنها. The jealousy of wife, the jealousy of a wife. She said to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, حسبك فإنها قصيرة. She did not say it. حسبك فإنها, she did like this, meaning she's short. And you know what? Safiya was short. Yes, she was short. But the context. You know what he said to her, صلى الله عليه وسلم, يا عائشة, O Aisha, if this word that you just said has a color, and if that color would mix with the water of the sea, it will change it. لقد قلت كلمة لو مزجت بماء البحر لمزجت. Why? It causes resentment, backbiting. Another reason, brothers and sisters in Islam, is love, loving positions, loving to be up front. And when you're not part of that, you're so angry, you're so upset. I'm not a leader. I'm not. And the moment that things are brought up, the person would bring it about. حب السيادة. All of these, brothers and sisters in Islam, are means to resentment. Our religion came to block it. A lot of us read this hadith. Don't, when your brother is buying, don't step in. While the deal is being in progress, لا يبع أحدكم على بيع أخيه ولا يخطب أحدكم على خطبة أخيه. And when your brother proposes to a sister, don't jump in there. Why? Because this will cause resentment. Here I am buying this and you're coming to buy it. Here I am proposing to the sister, you're coming to propose to her. Why? This will create resentment amongst us. It is time, brothers and sisters in Islam, to stop any of that. And I'm addressing all the communities. I hope you don't think that there is anything happened and that's why I'm bringing the subject up. Nothing really happened. But I can tell there is that lack of love. There is a lot of resentment. There is a lot of hate in the hearts of some of us. And it goes down as husband and wife. Husband and wife. A brother and a brother. Brothers who pray together. That shouldn't be there. If we are to pull our community together, our communities together as Muslim communities, and face the challenge. There is a lot of Islamophobia in America. And we have to face that. So far, we're so grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, thumma, then, to the community in Denver, Colorado, that nothing is happening. But we cannot be reactive. We have to be proactive. We have to find ways to get non-Muslims to learn about us. That one of the second holistic aim of our Sharia is the protection of the human life, whether he's a Muslim or not. The second greatest sin in Islam after shirk is taking the soul, the life of a human being unjustly. That's what we teach. This is what our religion is all about. They deserve to hear this. And we have to do this collectively. And for us to be together to do it collectively, we must be able to look at the face of one another. We must be able to feel comfort. I must feel peace about you. You cannot just look at me on the eye and smile and in my back be a vicious human being, be a poisonous snake. That is not right. Those are two faces. Have one face. A man with two faces in the day of resurrection will be treated with accordingly. It is time, brothers and sisters in Islam, that we love one another as Muslim communities. And I conclude by saying the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wal hadith fi sahih al-Imam Muslim hadith Abi Hurairah radiyallahu anhu qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam walladhi nafsi biyadi, by the one in whose hand my soul is, Allah la ilaha illa hu, lan tadkhulu al-jannata hatta tu'minu, you will never enter Jannah unless you believe, وَلَن تُؤْمِنُوا حَتَّى تَحَابُّوا, and you will never have faith unless you love one another. أَلَا أَدُلُّكُمْ عَلَى شَيْءٍ إِذَا فَعَلْتُمُوهُ تَحَابَبْتُمْ. Shall I direct you to something that if you do, you will love one another? أفشوا السلام بينكم. Spread peace. Peace is not just سلام عليكم ورحمة الله. لا. Peace that I feel peace. I look at you and I'm, this brother is not going to hurt me. This brother is not going to backbite about me. This brother is going to strive to clean his heart towards me. I feel peaceful. I know we're human beings and we have shortcomings, but we have a lot of community projects coming our way, and for us to make this happen, we must get over that to begin with. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين, له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل, وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له, وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وآله وصحبه وسلم. Brothers and sisters in Islam, no question that you're going to have people who resent you, because this is the human nature. And like I said, those people have not reached the reality of faith yet. They are just Muslims. They are just Muslims. They are not believers. Now, if you are a believer, meet that resentment with let go, forgiveness. There was a Sahabi whose name is Abu Dandam. Every single morning, he used to say, Ya Rab, I have no money to give in sadaqah. I have no power to do anything to benefit myself. But Ya Rab, anyone who backbit me, anyone, any Muslim who resent me, huwa fi hil, I forgive him. مصطح ابن أثاثة رضي الله عنه, صحابي whom أبو بكر الصديق رضي الله عنه was sponsoring him completely, housing, clothing, food. When he came to Medina, he was one of the people who promoted the rumor about Aisha radiallahu anha, which was triggered by the hypocrites in Medina. Here is somebody, you're taking care of him, and he's going after your honor, your daughter, who is the wife of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed Quran, regarding the innocence of Aisha radiallahu anha. Abu Bakr al-Siddiq makes that statement, I'm done with you. Go. No more help. I'm not going to help you. Allah reveals a verse in Surah Al-Nur. وَلَا يَأْتَلِ أُولُو الْفَضْلِ مِنْكُمْ وَالسَّعَةِ أَنْ يُؤْتُوا أُولِي الْقُرْبَى وَالْمَسَاكِينَ وَالْمُهَاجِرِينَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ وَلْيَعْفُوا وَلْيَصْفَحُوا أَلَا تُحِبُّونَ أَنْ يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ. As if the verse is talking about Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, and it was revealed regarding Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. Don't stop taking care of him and forgive. Don't you want to earn the forgiveness of Allah in return? Abu Bakr al-Siddiq رضي الله عنه يقول أحب يا رب أحب يا رب. I love to earn your forgiveness, Ya Allah. I love to earn your forgiveness. And in return, he restored his deal with Mustah. He carried on taking care of him. When you forgive, you're dealing with Allah, not with the people. You know what? 99% of the people will not appreciate that you let go. And they actually may think that you're weak. You're makhmoom al-qalb, you're a dummy. They may think that. Insult you, does all things to harm you. And you're letting go because of that deal with Allah, because you're a believer. You want the reward there. He may not appreciate that. But because you're doing it for Allah, don't stop it. This is what is going to take, brothers and sisters in Islam, our Muslim communities, to get together. Allahumma aghfir lana dhunubana وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من الفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن. اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها. اللهم حبب إلينا الإيمان وزينه في قلوبنا وكره إلينا الكفر والفسوق والعصيان واجعلنا من الراشدين. Brothers and sisters in Islam, a reminder tonight, inshallah, I'm going to our brothers in Fort Collins to help them complete their masjid. Yani, if you can help them, please do so. If you can come tonight to their fundraising, they are almost 75% to having a masjid in Fort Collins. And they want to pray Taraweeh and Ramadan there. If you please can help them with really... be rewarded. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وأقم الصلاة.